You know, we've been talking a lot about science and facts, and we know that sheltering in place has been quite difficult for all of us. The impact on us physically and, you know, emotionally, psychologically has been really challenging. Are there any insights that you could share as concluding thoughts?
Yeah, I think we know that this is a significant crisis to hit in our lifetime and many lifetimes, actually. I don't think anybody is alive today who has gone through an experience like this. Mm-hmm. And I think the impact of this is going to be on the future generations. And we're going to be in a new world, as I mentioned earlier. Not all of that is going to be bad. I think what I would love to focus on is the optimistic perspective that emerges from this crisis. And there are three things that I would like to really point out. Number one, I think we have really reprioritized. I think last few months, all of us, including myself and my family, we have actually realized that certain things are more important than the other things. We have learned to do with less. We have learned to focus on interpersonal relationships. We have learned that life can be uncertain. And the moment that we are in is probably the most important moment, and we need to make that moment count. Mm-hmm. I think all of that is really positive for our society. I think we probably will see shifting of our goals as a society. Mm-hmm. Maybe we'll care a lot more for our environment. We'll care a lot more for human relationships. Mm-hmm. I think that all of that is positive. The second thing that I'm, you know, being in Silicon Valley and being an innovator, I'm very enthused by the role of innovation in all of this. I mean, Stanford Biodesign works extensively with innovators in India, and innovators have had a front and center role in the way that country has dealt with this crisis. Young innovators have been leading the charge in coming up with new solutions, mm-hmm. for their communities. Mm-hmm. And that innovation is going to bend the cost outcome curve, as it's called. We're going to be able to do a far more with hopefully far less, mm-hmm. in the future. It's going to hopefully bring about new ways of doing things through technology, through other innovations, through care pathway innovations, through social innovations, through behavioral innovations. That would allow us to do things better in a more effective way. So that's a second silver lining that I see here. And then the last one, and this is not a done deal. This is a hope, as much hope as it's the evidence of this happening, is equity. I mentioned earlier, you know, the part of the community, part of the society that has been impacted the most by this disease have been the vulnerable, the poor, yeah. the disenfranchised. Mm-hmm. And the governments and the civic society has taken note of that, and they have actually stepped up in some ways to address that. The shelter in place happened for everybody in the Bay Area, right? So we all contributed to that. We all weighed in. They've been neighbors, my neighbors actually, who have made these masks that we actually benefited from ourselves. I chose not to take masks from our healthcare institutions that I'm involved in, because early on we need healthcare providers, our healthcare professionals, to have access to that. But our community, our neighbors actually made these masks and they distributed that in the community. Mm-hmm. Seva International, which is a nonprofit organization that works on pandemics and crises like these, they've been actually delivering food and groceries to old and the sick. So a lot of folks, there've been hotels, private hotels that have opened up their rooms for the homeless. Mm-hmm. So it's just been society has come together to really look out for the disenfranchised. My hope is that we take that to the next level, where governments, countries actually look out for each other, that they work with each other. Rich countries actually help out the poorer countries. Technologically more advanced countries actually help out countries that have a lot of work still to be done on technological front. I think we are seeing some really good evidence that people, at least at the people to people level, you know, there has been this desire to help each other. And my hope is that we become a global community as a result of this, and we address future crises, not just health crises or any crisis that hits that this world confronts. That we do this together, not as individuals or not as countries without official borders.
You know, they say with the greatest challenges in the world come the greatest opportunities as well. And I agree, it's been incredible to watch people come together, you know, while social distancing, figuring out ways to come together to help support one another in ways that, you know, you wouldn't see unless you had a crisis like this. So that's been really inspiring and hopeful.